Lisa Funk. I created the Guide to Mindful Lettering, and I am excited to share with you today the tools that I recommend you have to get started. So the truth is, all you really need is the book and a pen. Whichever pen that you decide you want to get started with. Really, any brush pen will work, even if it's a small brush pen, like this Tombow Feud pen. It will just be smaller on top of the lettering that you can trace. The lettering is all in gray in the book, and so you can trace just right on top of it. I love the Copic Multiliner Brush Medium pen, so that would be my first choice, especially for a beginner. It's really firm and just makes it really easy to create thin upstrokes and thick downstrokes. So that, this is a great one, kind of for a medium size. And then the Tombow Dual Brush Pen is a little bit larger, but it still would work great with this size for the book. And again, for the thick downstrokes and thin upstrokes. So all you really need is the book and one of these pens, or whichever brush pen you have. You can get a Crayola brush pen, you can get whatever brush pen you want to get started with. The other thing that I would recommend as like the next best thing to have if you want to get one more thing would be tracing paper. And this is just a kind that I like. You can get whatever kind you like. The reason why it's so nice is because you can take a piece of tracing paper, set it on top of your book, of your page, and trace so that you can use and reuse those pages. Once you do one time tracing straight into the book, it obviously won't be great anymore. So you'll want, you may want a way to get to trace over it again. And that is where the tracing paper comes in, and it's so handy. In addition, I'm just gonna share a couple of other things for you in case you're interested. I love the Rodia Dot Pad. It is a great lettering sketch pad. It just has this dot grid that you can use with a pencil and eraser, which I guess I should just cover that really quick. I love using a white eraser. I use any old pencil. I'm not a pencil snob, really. But I love using a white eraser when I'm erasing. And like the Rodia Dot Pad and the other papers I'm telling you about make it so easy to erase, and it's super smooth paper, doesn't bleed. The last paper that I want to tell you about is HP Premium Choice Printer Paper. It is printer paper, so it's not anything super fancy, but it is a step above your regular printer paper. If you use regular printer paper with your brush pens, you're gonna find that your brush pens fray and it kind of ruins them a little bit. It's also harder to get a really nice smooth stroke, and I get really frustrated with my lettering when I'm using a paper that has a lot of fiber in it, like a regular printer paper. Using this smooth HP Premium Choice, you're gonna get really a nice smooth finish, as well as it doesn't bleed. So this is super awesome. It's gonna be really nice on your brush pens, and even when you're just using a pencil and eraser, it just erases so much easier too. So these are just a couple of papers that are kind of nice to have around to sketch with. There's so many other fun supplies that I can link to, but one of the things that I love so much about lettering is that you don't need a million supplies. It doesn't have to be really expensive. You can really start with paper and a pen. And when you get started with this book, all you really need is just to grab one brush pen to get started with it. So that's why I love it. But of course, if you're interested in getting more supplies, I will link to some of those as well.